Hello, everyone, and welcome back to the next episode of Plasmaster Plays for Glory. Today we're finishing the Iron Man challenge that I started. Was it like 2 months ago or something? I have no idea. Man, time sure flew. Anyways, this is my Pac-Man. My Pac-Man is bad. It's Batman. But Pac-Man is such a fun character. Like, so many quirky gimmicks that you can throw out. And I love playing around with him from time to time, even though I'm not good with him. Pac-Man is definitely a character that I can appreciate. People who main him, you know, like Zage, one of my favorite competitive players to watch. It just does so much cool stuff with Pac-Man. You know, the hydrant combos and the bonus fruit combos. It's all awesome. It was a really long while ago when I played this match. I played this match before I even started getting footage for Wild Style, so it was quite a while ago, maybe 3 weeks. Then of course I focused on equipment style and Wild Style, so I didn't continue collecting footage for the next Plasmaster Plays for Glory episode. But after I finished Equipment Style 3, I decided that I'd finally get this done and get it out to you guys, so that's what you're watching right now. I hope you're enjoying it. Nothing's happened so far. I don't remember much about this Lucario player. He doesn't seem like he's particularly that bright. That force bomb would have killed, but the push boxes from the hydrant saved my life. Oh my gosh. There we go. Let's see. He got me with that one. What has developed recently, that I haven't told you guys about? Let's see. Well, I just got registered for SmashCon, last night, actually. And I'm really excited for that already. I'm going to be on a doubles team with my friend, N. Used to be known as Nyan. But he's N now. Not sure. I don't know. I never really asked him. But yeah. He and I are going to be on a doubles team, so that's exciting. We probably won't get very far, if at all, but you know what, it'll still be fun to participate and compete, and to prepare for the match, you know. Okay, I think this match is just about done. Excuse me, my gosh! Yeah, he's dead. Oh, I guess not. Right here. Yeah, alright, nice. Yeah, I remember a lot of the other matches a lot better, so, you know, you can expect better commentary for those. So, another thing, I actually, started and finished getting footage for Bowser Style this week, already. I actually finished getting footage for it on, Sunday. So, you know, I worked quickly to, get all the footage recorded and done, like right after I finished Equipment Style 3. I'm thinking that I might even just release Bowser Style 3 a little earlier than I usually release Smash Style videos. You know, I usually release them every other Friday. But considering that I'm already done with Bowser Style, and I'm eager to get on to the next Smash Style already, I'd be perfectly fine with just uploading it this week. So I'll probably do that. Yeah, and it's actually a good one, too. I got some good footage. I don't know. It's not, like, top-level Bowser play, but, I definitely got a lot better with Bowser, through this last week, and, I actually was a bit, what was I saying? I completely forgot. I actually went back and watched, Alpharad's How to Play Bowser, and I watched a few other Bowser, montages as well, and I think my, footage is actually better than some of the stuff that is in those montages. I mean, obviously, it's again, not top-level Bowser play, but, you know, it's still good. Not bad. Not anything to write home about either, but, you know, still good, is what I'm trying to say. And, is this what, did he get killed by this? I think I killed him right here. No, I didn't. Alright. Another thing. If you want to learn how to pivot grab, just play Bowser. very, very easy character to learn how to pivot grab with, because his pivot grab is so damn good. I actually was unable to pivot grab before. I can't do a lot of, more advanced stuff. In Smash, partially because of, you know, my control scheme with the 3DS and all that. Yeah, makes it a little more difficult to play. But as I was saying, I actually learned how to pivot grab, and I can do it pretty effectively now too. Yeah, I can do it with just about any character now. I know that pivot grabbing is very important to Samus because of her extremely long grab range. Pivot grabs are very useful to her, and I think pivot grabs are actually her fastest grab. It has the least lag out of all of her grabs. So, you know, knowing how to pivot grab is very useful. I actually use R and A to grab. I just press them at the same time. To grab, and it's a bit unorthodox. I will admit that, but I actually when I'm doing pivot grabs, I use the Y button because I have that set to grab. So that way, tethering ledges is easier with Samus. I just press Y instead of R and A because, you know, sometimes you press R and A and the game thinks that you either want to air dodge or you want to attack, and then you end up dying. So, yeah, this match with Sonic went pretty quickly, actually. Something about Sonic. I actually am very annoyed by his character. I know a lot. Well, It's not necessarily because everybody hates on Sonic in Smash because of his stupid combos, his extremely fast speed, his up air ceiling kills, and yeah, this was it right here. I killed him. He's dead. That's a dead Meta Knight. Yeah, personally, just not a fan of Sonic. Not a fan of the Sonic games, any of that. Just a personal thing, I guess. Alright, and now moving on to my Mewtwo. This Pikachu player was actually pretty good. He gave me a run for my money. But I managed to pull through in the end. I don't remember how, but I did. It was a close match, a very close match. Obviously knew what he was doing with Pikachu. I never really play as Pikachu in Smash. I oftentimes forget that he's even in the game, to be honest. I don't play as most Pokemon characters. You can see there I'm doing pivot grabs with Mewtwo. It's because I played these matches right after I was finished collecting footage for Bowser Style, so you know I was better about getting pivot grabs, so... That was so dumb. We just kept spot dodging each other's stuff right there. Finally, he was like, you know what, I'm just jab. He's like, I'm not wasting any more time with this. Oh boy. So, I say so too much. Something interesting about Mewtwo is that he was actually planned to have custom moves, for those who don't know. He was actually planned to have custom moves. I don't remember why they didn't put custom moves in, but he didn't end up getting custom moves, obviously. I think that if he had, that the other custom, or not custom, DLC characters probably would have had custom moves as well. And it's kind of cool to, like, think of ideas for these custom moves for these characters, because they're all so, they're such odd characters, you know, like Cloud. How do you make a custom special for Cloud's down B limit charge? Like, how do you even do that? The only thing I can really think of is that, like, maybe the little box, the little meter above Cloud, has a hitbox on it with one of the customs, but it takes longer to charge as, like, kind of a trade-off. I don't know, that was just an idea that I had one day. I thought it was kind of interesting. But, I mean, an obvious one for Mewtwo is, for his Shadow Ball, is give him his melee Shadow Ball back. You know, have it deal damage while you're charging it. I actually think that maybe that was one of his custom moves. Or maybe an idea for one of his custom moves when he was in, development. When I first played Mewtwo, I didn't like that they'd taken away that hitbox on the charging Shadow Ball. And I understand why they did it. It's to differentiate him more from Lucario. You know? Because Lucario has the charging hitbox on his Aura Sphere. And, they wanted to, you know, make Mewtwo more different from Lucario. But it's like, they both have a charging projectile for their neutral special. They both have command grab for their side B. You know, like, there's already a few things that they have in common. Yeah. Let's see. My Mewtwo, not too bad. Definitely could be a lot better. I love doing platform and edge cancels with teleport. Those are so fun. Like, just all the combos you can do with those are just so much fun. And I like to use teleport to land sometimes. Especially against characters that are good at juggling, because, you know, Mewtwo has those he's a very lightweight character and floaty, so he's not too easy to juggle, but, you know, he still has large hitboxes, or hurtboxes, rather, so, you know, he's not necessarily combo food, but he certainly does get comboed more easily than some of the other lightweights out there. This guy, he could have killed me with any one of those jolt, thunder jolts. You know, like, I just needed a grab, that's all I needed, I knew it. Alright. Wow, I didn't realize that match was almost to the... It almost went to sudden death. That's crazy. Okay, here's my Lucas. My Brawl Lucas is on point. Smash 4 Lucas, not so much. Like, I know the combos with Smash 4 Lucas. I don't know. Something about Lucas, I'm not very good with it. That down tilt looks so funny when you spam it, because he's just like, you spin me right around. He looks really funny. Gosh. As I was saying, when I was collecting footage for this For Glory episode, I lost so many times as Lucas. Like, no joke, I was doing horribly. I just managed to get lucky enough to get this guy, who even then almost lost to. Still really good player. Yeah. Quite evident. I love Lucas's back air. I like to reverse aerial rush that for spacing. Like, short hop back air just looks so cool with Lucas. And then I don't know how the hell that worked, but I somehow got him with that. It was so stupid. Oh boy. So last night, I made myself a bacon and egg sandwich. That was delicious. And while I was making it, I was talking to some guys in the Robin Discord, and one of them noticed that my profile picture was a character from Ben 10, you know, that old show, that cartoon. I watched that all the time when I was a kid. I loved that show. And now my little brother, he watches it quite a bit now. Because he and I would play the Ben 10 Wii game together. And I told him it was actually a TV show. And he was like, oh, can we watch it? And I was like, yeah, sure. So we watched it. Still watching it, actually. We haven't finished watching this series yet. Anyways, as I was saying, me and this guy, we talked for like an hour about old cartoons. Like, we talked about Generator Rex. Like, I completely forgot about Generator Rex. That show was so good. And like, after like the second season or so, I stopped watching it because I actually forgot completely about it. I think that it just started premiering on nights when I was not home or something, so I just didn't watch it, and this guy just brought it up, and I was like, oh my gosh, I remember that show, it was so good. We also talked a bit about Adventure Time. That, oh man, that's a good show. I actually can't believe it's still on. I mean, I'm glad it is, I just thought that they might have pulled the plug on it by this point. Because it's... Man, when did that show come out? 2009? 2010? I think 2009. Like, September of 2009 it came out. And it's still going. 8 years. That's crazy. And I think it has 8 seasons now, too. Actually, it was, a couple months ago, I was going back and re-watching the series, and then I, forgot about it. But last night I started, after I talked to this guy, I started... going back and rewatching it again. I'm on season 4 now, I think. I don't know. I can't remember. I think season 4, because season 5, the first episode of season 5 is the one where Jake meets Prismo. And I know I hadn't gotten to that part in the series yet. This Ryu, not very competent. A lot of lag during these matches, too, actually. Very laggy. The Mega Man one was pretty laggy. And there was, another one. I don't think we've gotten to it yet. It was really laggy, though. I think it was the Ryu match that I played. It was really laggy. It was awful. No, it was actually the Cloud match, now that I think about it. But yeah, there, a couple of these matches were laggy. Not really input lag, but it was like every 3 seconds, that little loading thing in the bottom corner would show up, and it'd be like, ah! I cannot, does not compute! Oh gosh. Yeah. So after Bowser Style, I'm going to be coming up with Fun Style, which is just gonna be me going on for fun and just messing around and seeing what kind of dumb, silly stuff I can get. I actually already have a few matches recorded for that too. Yeah. For fun, like, it's stupid, and that's why I love it. I mean, I don't play on it as much as I do for Glory, but, you know, it's still fun to play on for fun for a while. Oh, man. Speaking of cartoons, anybody in my audience who watches Rick and Morty, who really enjoyed that, that Season 3 premiere, I loved it. I absolutely loved it. I wasn't expecting it to happen the way it did, but I'm so glad it did. It was great. Yeah, I can't wait until, the rest of the third season comes out in, I think, is it May or June that it's coming out? Oh my gosh. I don't remember. But yeah, that's a great show. I've been trying to get my friend, Allison to watch it, but she won't. And I'm like, come on, you can make me watch Naruto if you watch Rick and Morty. And she's like, no, I don't want to make you watch it. I was like, well, I don't like anime, so, you know, like, I know you'll like Rick and Morty, you just gotta give it a chance. Same with Adventure Time, she has not watched Adventure Time, and I know she'll love it, just because of her personality, she'll love Adventure Time. Yeah, so this match started out with some lag, and then I think the guy got replaced with an AI, and I just destroyed him. Not necessarily destroyed him, but I beat him. Like, yeah, right there, I was still unsure if it was an AI or not, so I just kind of walked up to see what he would do when he jabbed, and I was like, yep, that's an AI. Definitely an AI. Oh, gosh. Let's see. Oh, the new, that new Nintendo Direct, for those of you who didn't watch it, I suggest that you go back and watch it if you do enjoy Nintendo, that is, because it was great. Lots of great stuff shown off, in that Direct. Really excited for Splatoon 2 and ARMS, actually. Still don't quite have enough for Breath of the Wild, so I'm still holding off on getting the Switch, but I'm looking forward to it. These next three matches were all fought against the same guy, and he was terrible. Really, just obviously does not grasp the concept of Smash. Clearly he knows what the A button does, and clearly he knows how to use up B and side B in the neutral. As Sheik, like an idiot. Yeah, he would just, he'd throw them out whenever. Yeah. He tried to use up B to escape a combo, and then I just hit him on the way back down, and it was just kinda, I was disappointed that finishing touch, missed, actually. Very disappointed. And he's dead. Oh my gosh. That is one of the coolest moves in Smash. Like, every character, I think, has like, a move that they're known for, you know? And for Cloud, it's definitely gotta be the Limit Cross Slash. Like, that's just one of the coolest looking moves. I love it so much. I mean, I think a lot of people would say that Finishing Touch is the move that he's most known for, but I disagree. Just Limit Cross Slash, it looks freaking awesome. It's a kill move, it does a lot of damage, and it's a great combo finisher. Like, it's... Oh my gosh, such a great move. I mean, yeah, like, every character has, like, a move, or maybe even two moves that they're known for. You know, Ganon has his down air and his up tilt, you know, and his Ganon side. Captain Falcon, obviously, has the Falcon Punch, and what the heck is this guy doing? And the Knee of Justice. Those are, like, his, those are his moves, you know? And he's gonna show them to you. Yeah. I think that's another thing about Smash that's just pretty great, you know? Is that... I don't know, it's got kind of like... It's got its own audience, really, you know? Well, I spent too much time messing around with that guy. Word of warning, this is one of the dumbest matches I've ever played. Oh my gosh, and it's with Corrin too. I don't like Corrin. I mean, I like Corrin in Smash. Corrin in Smash is fine. Just fine. It's Corrin in Fates, Fire Emblem Fates, that I have a problem with. And that's because he slash she sucks. A lot. Really a lot. And I took that first stock really easily. Oh gosh. Yeah. Anyways, Corrin. Fun character in Smash. Like, the side B. Oh my gosh, the side B is amazing. Like, it's so safe. It's like one of the safest moves in the game. Like, I love that move so much. And for those who don't know or don't remember, I actually used to main Corrin. I actually mained Corrin, like, the first day Corrin came out, played him, decided I was gonna main him, and I took a bunch of replays from my first day Corrin, and made them in the Corrin style too, not Corrin style too, Corrin style, which was my first video on the channel. Yeah, that was actually my day one Corrin that was in that montage. Looking back now, not an impressive montage, and also horrible quality. Oh my gosh, it sucked. Alright, last match of my For Glory Iron Man challenge mini-series as part of my Plasmaster Plays For Glory series. I was just throwing out side Bs to see how many times I could hit this guy with it. Yeah, I just kind of messed with this guy. Oh my gosh. Anyways, I hope you guys enjoyed this little mini-series. Now, you can actually say if you have a character that you wanted to see me play as, then you've seen me play as them. And, like, that doesn't mean I won't play as that character again. You know, I want to try and get some variety in the characters that I play in each episode of this series. But, you know, you know what I mean. Anyways, Bayonetta. Fun character to play as, not fun to play against. I personally don't like the character all that much. I don't know. I got mixed feelings about Bayonetta. I was a bit disappointed when she was confirmed for Smash, because I, first off, I wasn't too familiar with the Bayonetta games, so I didn't really know much about her except the controversial stuff that people would talk about her, about, I guess, is what I'm trying to say. Yeah. So, there was that, and then there's also that it wasn't Zant or Bandana D. I was disappointed by that. I really wanted it to be Zant. We needed a new Zelda character for this Smash. We also need more villains for Smash. Zant, prime contender, if you ask me. Also, Zant is my favorite Zelda villain in the whole Zelda series. Just a really, really great character. I really like Zant. And with that, the Four Glory Iron Man Challenge has concluded. I hope you guys enjoyed it. I will be back to making regular episodes of this series next week. I'm definitely going to try and upload an episode of this next week. Yeah, and until next time, keep on smashing and leave it to Heropon.